friends, welcome to Srinu Technologies. Myself Ram Kumar. Today we will discuss more about this Object Studio. So in our previous video we have seen how we can launch an application and then spy some elements, get the HTML content out of it. So we will try to see how we can use this action or a page from process, and then we will see the logical structure how it is there, right? So let's get started. So we have seen this all stuff actually. So now we'll go through the logical structure. I think to stress on stages, right? I think we have seen read stage, write stage. We will see another use case. Navigate we have used. Code stage I will tell you. So wait stage we have used three as of now: read, navigate, wait. So, like we have yet to cover some more stages from Process Studio also, right? So we will mix those all and then do it as part of separate use case. So this is like a start point, you can take it and then we can get started, right? So logical flow. So when we are saying this, so in a process how it is there is, you would understand that when we have a main page, we are having some page one or sub process which we are called, right? So main page is calling the sub process one, and sub process one can call sub process two. So it's like that. And then as I told you, the control or the execution starts from main page, right? So that is what we have noticed here. Even though we are on page 2 or page 3 or any other page, when we click on go, it is starting from the main page. So we have provisions to start from anywhere, means we have to do a hard code or do a control change like go to the stage or something. But by default, so I am telling about from by default perspective, when we are initiating run or executing the run in Process Studio, it is starting from main page. So what you understand, if you see this diagram, so the process line is starting here. From the process it is coming to a business object, and then again going back to the process, and then it is coming to the page one or something like this. So these objects, business object pages are there which we have said. So those are called actions. Every page in a business object is called action, right? And unlike process, no need for us to go in a sequence. If you see the diagram here, based on our need, page 3 is called first. After the page 3, again it went back, the control went back to the process, and then again page 1 is called, and then went back to the process, again page 8 is called, and again went back to process, and then the process is completed. So we will just see the steps how it is there. I will get you know how we can do this, okay? So for now understand that from process perspective, default will be main page, and we cannot execute individually by default, right? But if it is an action stage, it's in a business object, every action alias page, right? Every page in business object or every action in business object can be called independently. So this is the thumb rule you have to make, right? So how we call it? So how we call an action or a page which is there in process, business object from process? So we, by using an action stage. So action stage is similar to a page reference in that it takes the flow of the process down to another page, but instead of it being a page of the same diagram, it is the page of a business object, an entirely separate diagram. Means what it mean to say is, when we are using a process, so let me go back to the tool. I think I can explain you much better on tool, right? So what they are saying is, if you see here, main page is calling some page called loop page, right? So this is loop page is part of main page. Means loop page is part of the same process. That's what it is saying in the statement, that when we are having this, where a page, the main page is calling a sub page or a sub process which we call, and that is part of the same process, it's not a different thing. But if you use an action stage which is there on the left, if you see here, if I pull this action stage here, I can use the object or the action which is available in different altogether object which is called an object studio, right? So we'll just see the steps. Before doing that, I think if you remember, we have published the process, and because of which the published process is available in control room. Similarly, we have to publish an object or the action, specific action. Example, think that you have 10 actions in your business object. Whatever actions or the pages which you publish will be visible to this process studio or the process. And one more thing is, once you publish, you might be in a concept that published object will be available or can be seen from control room. No. So the thumb rule is, once you publish an object, pages or an action, so it will be visible to process only. So the published pages in a process are visible to a control room. So that is a hierarchy. Okay. So control room cannot see the published pages which are in the business object. Control room can see the pages which are published from a process only. Right. So let me go back to the object and then see how we can do this. So if you see here, these two are by default published. Right. So for this, we have to make it published. So simple. For process, what we went? We went to the information box and then clicked on a checkbox. But here it is directly available for us. Okay. So I say publish. So once I say publish, it will be available for a process which it can reuse. So what we'll do is, before closing this, we will return the HTML data as an output for this action. For that, what you have to do, I think you know the steps. So I have opened the end stage, and then I'm selecting the data which I want. And I said add, and then I will drag it into the get value from. Once I leave it, the database is there, and then this is HTML output is the variable name I am keeping. Right? I said okay. So this will be, once this process executes or once this action is executed, so it will read the current temperature from that browser or the application. Okay, let me save this. Or let us have one more action. So get temperature is what it is by default. So I'm creating a new, and then I will say, what we'll say is get city from data. So I want to read the city name, specific name inside it. That is my action which I want to do. Right, I am having multiple actions now. For this, what is the input now? Input will be the, so what is the name? So we will give some name like input text data. Okay. So what is the type? It should be a text. I am storing it in the same variable. So if you see here, this is the input text which we have got. Okay. Now, so this is the input text which we have got now. So what we have to do, once we get that thing, I want to do a calculation. Okay. I want to do some calculation, and then we will see how we can calculate. So I will have one more variable data item which will be used for storing the city value. If you see the output of earlier HTML, so it was like city name was there, temperature name was there. Okay. Now we will break it into multiple things. So it's a text, and then it is empty, right? Instead of having the complete data, I am extracting city name from it. Okay. So what I will do is, so this is the calculation. So store it in. So I want whatever is retrieved from this input data, I want to store it in city. So store result is in city. So this expression, you have to do it something so that then you retrieve the required data from the input text data variable. So we have, if you see here, there are some functions here. So you can explore each and every one, but for time being, I will go with some text actually, where there are many things. If you see here, left, right, split. The one good thing is, when you select on anything, if I select on this left, so what it is saying is, there are two input fields for this, where if you give the length and the input text, and then based on the length, if you give some text value as example, and then the length as 3, it will return you the first three, means from left it will take three characters and then that is given as output. So for us we have many characters, so but we will see what is there from left. We can use this. So I will drag this input text data into the text field. If you see here, these are input thing. Length I will keep as something, some random 8. I'm just taking it something. So and then I will say paste. When I say paste, if you see here, this is the expression it is created. So this expression when it get executes, if I will give some. So the good thing is you can do something called validate. Validate means whether the expression is wrong or not. If I will enter something like 1, 2, 3, something like this, I have entered outside it, right? And then I will say validate. So it will say that there is some syntax error. Okay, then I will correct it. So now I have done some corrections. Now I will do a validate. Validate will tell us the expression is valid. You can evaluate the expression, means you have created an expression and you want to see for the given inputs what will be the output. You can evaluate an expression. If you see here, it is asking me, give me the input text data and then I will give you the output of the expression which is mentioned above. So I will give something like this. If you see here, I have given a big text and then in the starting I will give some characters also like this. So this is how I am giving. So when I say test, if you see here, it is giving the leftmost 8 characters. Okay, that is what it is giving here. So we can have many such kind of evaluations and functions can be used here for our own purpose. So by clicking on it, you will understand what is each value is there here. Okay, I think you got the context. So we will say that get city name. This is what I am saying. This is the calculation stage. So this will return us what will be there in the city. So this should return. If you remember, one thing you have to remember is everything should be returned. It's better so that, because once you are doing something, you have to keep in your mind that these actions will be called from a process, right? So you have to keep that in mind. Okay, so one thing is, there might be chance that the text which is coming, you will be having some trailing spaces. We want to remove that spaces and then you want to do something, right? In that case, we can have use multi-calc. I said, right, when there is a scenario, we will think of adding more things. So calculation, if you have two calculations, what you will do, you will have this kind of get city name on the next or the next calculation one by one as a sequence you will be keeping. Rather than having multiple stages, you can have multi-calc actually. So we will have the same thing here also, if you see here. So I will do two steps here. So multi-calc, so the same thing I am doing here. So if you know, right, it has expression and where the value to be stored. So if you click on expression and if you click on this expression icon, again it will open the same window which a calculation thing is opened for you, right? So that is how it is nicely done. So I will go to the same thing and then before applying the left, I will say trim. So what it is saying, if you see here, if there is a space between example and after example, it will remove the space. That is the intention of trim. So that's what I'm doing here. I want to remove any spaces are there in the input text. That's what I'm doing. And then I will say okay. So when I say okay, it will ask where to be stored. I want this to be stored in input text data itself, means I am copying the content from the input text data variable, doing some trim operations, and the output is again stored into input text variable only. Now I will say add. When I am saying add, it's a multi-calc, right? Means multiple calculations can be done in a sequence at one go. So what I want to do, so the expression which we have seen earlier, so I will store in city. What is the expression I will keep? I will use left and then the variable is this and then length is 8. So I will paste and then I will say okay. If you see here, what I am doing is first I am trimming the data and then storing it to the same variable, and then that variable data is taken and then the first 8 characters on the left side are being stored into CT. So this is multi-calc. I think we have covered one more stage here. We got some opportunity and then we have used it. Okay, so this is what is city. obviously we have to return the city here. So I will say add, I want to return the city name, and then so name is city name. So this is a variable name which we will be seeing on the calling. One more thing you have to remember is, yes, we have to publish this action so that we will see this. You want to see whether it is coming or not. So let's don't publish this, and then we will see how from a process which actions we are able to see and which we are not. Okay, let me save this. No need to check this because it's a simple calculation, so I am not validating here. I will directly check from process. I am closing this object studio, and then I will close the process studio also so that it reflects properly, right? So sometimes it's better to close and open, right? Now I will open. So once you have this process studio, so we will have a loop page and this thing. So we will have a new process, that is better, because I will not make this. So create process, what we are trying to do is, the process is get temperature. So this is our process, get temperature. Okay, so finish, this is our new process. I'll open this. By default we are in main page, so you have to be clear on what will be happening on what. Okay, now I am saying, what I am saying is, I am calling the action now. So this is, if you open this, business object and action. So business object is what, if you remember, we have created some name called browser Google. This is the business object we have created, visual business objects, VBOs we call. Okay, this is the business object we have created, which is having the capability to open a browser and log into some go to some application and extract the temperature details from that thing. So I will click on it. So if you see here, there is only one action here. Getting clear? So there is one action here. If you remember, there are actually four actions in our business object. They are initialize, clean up, get temperature, and then some get city name, if I'm not wrong, right? So but only one thing is given, because this is published. Even though initialize and clean up are published, those are not visible, because those are the things which the bot will be calling by default. So no need for a process to explicitly call those actions. That is the intent there. Okay, you have to understand. So I will say, what I will say is, so this action name I will say get temp. So when I say this thing, there are no input for this because it is opening the browser and is getting it. But what is output? If you see here, this is the output which we are referring to. Then I will say HTML output, I will give the same value, and then I will say OK. So if you just see it here, what is happening is, I am calling an task from a process. Okay, the task is getting the temperature from a site. So which, as a site, process cannot directly access a site application. So it is coming to an object, it is calling a business object, and the business object is getting the temperature for us. Let us quickly run this. So this is called an action stage which we are using inside a process, if you see. Let us see, run this. Get temperature, it is opening a browser, type the URL. Page getting loaded, closed. If you see here, we have the complete output. Now we have the complete output here. This we have to see in the current value. Yes, so you should not forget the basics. So these are the four values we are getting. And if you see here, there is some space here also, starting, if you see here, right? So what I will do is, I will give this as an input to the next action, and then I will retrieve only city name. Okay, so but here one problem which we have to see is, the other action is not published. So I will open that first. Okay, browser Google is this thing, and then this is what we are talking to, and then I will say right click and publish, over, save. close it. Now, sometimes we might be see a malfunction when like we are not able to see the action name again, even though it is published. But here we have got actually. Sometimes you might not be getting these two once we are closing the Object Studio. Better you just close the process studio and then reopen it. It will definitely work for you, right? So now this output of get temperature should be given to as an input to CT data. So that is an action. Earlier in our previous process, we have called a page. That's what we are saying. So it's a sub process called at that stage. This is we are calling an action in from an VBO, that is visual business object. So what is the name is, action name is this thing, get CT name from data. If you see here, it is asking for some input text data. What is the input text data? Our HTML output is the input text data. What is the output? CT name. I am clicking on this icon so that the variable is created. This is get CT name. Okay, so this is what it is there. So let me link this so that it will be clear for you. So I will make some alignments so that it looks good for us, right? So let me increase the text size so that the visibility will be nice for us. We are having huge data in XML, so HTML is having big data. CT is what we want to keep it here. I am making it big for your readability perspective. Refresh, save it. Right, let me run this. Get temperature, it will go, get the temperatures. This is also called screen scraping, right? So through spying we have done, and then city name, if you see here, it has got the New York. So this is how we can do it. So there is some problem here where one thing is, it is New York. If it is other city, we have given 8 spaces here in our Object Studio, which might fail for bigger countries, right? So let us I think that can be done using a calculation, very simple, but we will see that how to use some exceptions we can add so that we will understand. We will cover all the stages and then we will add some more content to it or the use cases, and then we will understand from that perspective. Okay, make sure you are exploring everything. Each thing is explanatory, so I am just giving a startup for you, and then we will continue in the next video, right? Hope you all have understood. Keep watching our videos, keep learning.